Hello and welcome to Chrome Computing. In this video, we'll be looking at the Asus C302 Chromebook. Now, I know what you're thinking, this isn't the newest Chromebook out there. That's absolutely correct, because Chromebooks over the last few years have grown substantially. You can now get some real high-spec Chromebooks. A few years ago, this was the Chromebook of choice. The Asus C302 was the Chromebook of choice. Now, it is a few years old, so yes, it obviously isn't the highest spec Chromebook you can get. However, it is a great Chromebook if you're after a budget Chromebook, because where the higher spec Chromebooks have gone is great for people who want high spec Chromebooks. Low budget Chromebooks, they're good, but they are low budget Chromebooks, so there's always something that you're giving up. Whether that's the display, the processor, the RAM and storage, the keyboard, the feel of the actual Chromebook. And that's where the Asus C302 sits in really nicely, because it's a great Chromebook and you can get it at great prices. We'll be looking at prices later on in this video, and I'll show you where you can get this Chromebook at a great price. So continue watching. Don't skip through the video, because I'm going to go through the review pretty well on this. I'm going to really go dive into the Asus C302 so you can see if it's right for you. If you like the video, please like underneath and subscribe to the channel, because I'll be doing future reviews of Chromebooks. So let's take a closer look at the Asus C302 Chromebook. As you can see, it's silver and it's got an aluminium body all over on the outside, which is great when you consider you'd be buying this as a budget Chromebook. Not all budget Chromebooks come with an all outer casing made of aluminium. It's got some plastic feet here, which is great. It makes it not slip when it's on the surface, so that's really good. Open up the Chromebook, and it's also aluminium inside, which is also great. There it is, logging up. It's a Chromebook, so it logs up pretty quickly. The display is really good. It's a 12.5-inch display. It's got touchscreen, so you can use Android apps as well. It's got IPS, so the viewing angles are fantastic. It goes pretty bright as well. If we turn the brightness up, as you can see, right down, right up to the top. It's got a fantastic keyboard to type on. I absolutely love typing on this Chromebook. It's excellent. Opens up browsers in no time, as you would expect, but the keyboard is really, really nice to type on. Just go to my website there. As you can see, it loads up pretty quick. As far as the performance is concerned, there's no problems at all. It's got an Intel M3 processor. It's really quick. I've never had any problems with this Chromebook. I know higher spec Chromebooks now come with the Intel Pentium i3, i5, i7 range, which is possibly fine, but also possibly overkill. You really don't need it, because the performance of this Chromebook is absolutely fantastic. There's nothing wrong with it whatsoever. It comes with 4GB of RAM, which is perfectly fine as well. Yes, if you're going to get a brand new high spec Chromebook, you'd be looking at more like 8GB RAM, but you know, the 4GB RAM on offer is absolutely fine. It also comes with 64GB of storage, which is enough for whatever you would want to do. Also, if you wanted to, you can upgrade the storage, because there's a micro SD slot there, which is fantastic to see. It's also got a USB on that side, and it's got a USB on that side, so you can charge either side, which I think is really good, and it definitely comes in handy depending where you've got the Chromebook, whether you want it on that side or that side, which is good. It's got the volume up and down there, and there's the power switch, and it's got a little light there if it's charged, and it's amber, and when it's fully charged, it's green. There's the sound. We'll wait for the bass to kick in. Don't expect it to be a great on the bass, because it does sound a bit tinny straight away here. But it does sound good, fine. Have a listen. It sounds perfectly fine. No problems there at all. I'll turn that off, because I don't want a copyright strike for using someone's music in the video. So yeah, that's perfectly fine. Now, in relation to the actual device, It's a hybrid. If you don't know what a hybrid Chromebook is, it means it can be used as a laptop like this here now, or it can be used as a tablet by just turning it over like that. And the great thing is with this Chromebook, not all Chromebooks have it, there's a magnet here, so it clicks into place, which is really good because it makes it a really nice, sturdy connection when it's in tablet mode. As you can see, you have to pull it a bit to open it back into laptop mode. So it works fine in tablet mode. Personally speaking, I don't use it much in tablet mode, if I'm being honest with you, but Chrome OS has definitely improved, so it works with tablets now much better than it did do back in the day. I would use it more like this if I wasn't going to be using it as a laptop, because that works perfectly on my settee. If I'm using it on my settee and I've got it on the arm, it's really good like that. On a train as well, it's really good to use like that. So that's the one good thing I do like about hybrid Chromebooks. It's not just having it in tablet mode, it's the other modes you can have it in. You can have it in temp mode, which is that, which is fine as well if that's what you, that's how you like it. You can change it to any way you want it really, but personally speaking, I prefer it much like that. And the reason why I like it like that, they've actually added 2, 3, 4 rubber, well actually there's 6, there's 2 there as well, 6 little rubber legs there, so when you've got it as tablet mode like that, it sticks to the table, it doesn't swap, which is great. Obviously if you've got it in temp mode, that's not so much the case. So yes, it's really good as a laptop or a tablet or in temp mode. I've got no problems with this Chromebook at all. The trackpad works perfectly fine. The webcam is okay, you know, what would you expect? It's not fantastic, but there's not many webcams that are fantastic in a Chromebook at this price. The battery, it lasts a long time, it's really good. I normally get about, I don't know, say 5, 6, 7 hours from this, and that's considering using videos, streaming music, streaming videos. So it does last a long time. If I was just going on the internet and or using Google Docs during the day, I think I'd get about 8 hours out of it, which is really good. The keyboard is backlit as well, and it's just a really good Chromebook. The hinges are really sturdy, and I love the slab look of this Chromebook. I absolutely love Chromebooks that have got a slab like look to them. And what I mean by that is there's no curves here at the bottom or at the top. There's a lot of Chromebooks and just laptops in general that do, but this doesn't, and I really like that. I just think it makes it look really sturdy. Also, the great thing is that it isn't squared edges here, it's curved, and that is not only looks nice, it's really nice to hold. It makes it so much nicer taking this out and about with you. It is a great Chromebook. I can't recommend this Chromebook anymore for anyone who's looking for a budget Chromebook. Well, I hope you found that video really useful. If you did, please like the video and subscribe to the channel for future Chromebook reviews. If you want to see the latest prices for the Asus C302, I've got a link in the description below to my website, and you'll be able to see the latest prices both in the UK and the USA. Thanks for watching.